I think the reality is, though, that both sides going into this game will realise that England are the strong favourites. But, you know, Quinton de Kock, Rabada, you can think of Nokia. They have some fantastic players who can turn a game, who can just flip a game on its head.
We're not afraid of being all that we are. No limit here to tell us just how far.
This is the Alienware Presents SK Yacht. And of course, this is where we get you all the preview of the big matches. And this one, the one that we have in our hands today, is England versus South Africa in Sharjah. And to elevate my gameplay, may I please call upon the man who is a live wire on the field and a pundit in the commentary box. I've got with me Nick Knight. Hey, Nick. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Very good morning to you. It's bright and early here in England, but it's always great to speak to you.
It is indeed. And it's bright and colourful right behind me because we've got Diwali festivities in India. So yellow is the colour of the season. But having said that, the flavour of the season is England. You must be very happy with the way they've been performing.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we in England, we get pretty greedy with our team, actually, because they've achieved so much in the last few years, of course, winning the 50-over World Cup. That the expectation is there. They will feel that. And the way they've started with the four wins has been outstanding. I think Morgan's captaincy has been unbelievably good. We know he's a very fine leader, but the way he's manipulated his bowlers, the way he's brought them in and out of the attack, the way his matchups have all worked so well for him, and the way his gut feel as a captain has worked, and his bowlers have followed. He's won the toss a few times, which has been handy as well, and his top order is fired. So everything is very much in order for England.
You've got two more teams right behind them. You've got Australia and South Africa. Australia's playing West Indies. But later in the evening, we've got South Africa playing England. Now, South Africa has improved its net run rate and it seems to be a battle of the best in that particular group. Whereas you've got England, of course, as a boss on the top of the points table. But what do you fare the chances of Australia and South Africa getting in the semis? Who do you think is a better chance?
And I think the way Australia have played has been pretty good. So if I'm being honest with you, I think Australia, but that's because South Africa have obviously got to play England. South Africa are a good side. I mean, they've got some high quality players, but I think at the moment, Australia are the better side.
This one's happening in Sharjah. What does Sharjah as a venue tell you?
Well, I mean, I worked on the IPL out there, but it tells me that it's a slow pitch and short boundaries. So what we can expect from England is just to manoeuvre that bowling attack around to accommodate the situation and to accommodate the batsmen that are in at the time.
So let's talk about the match that we have, which is South Africa and England. Interestingly, in a head-to-head record in World Cup, South Africa has a better record. But, you know, this T20 World Cup has been very interesting because of the stats that we see on paper. Somehow on the field, it's a very different story.
I think you kind of ruined it for me. I was so positive about England and now South Africa got something to hold their hat on to. I mean, obviously, stats are stats and they go back a certain amount of time. I think the reality is, though, that both sides going into this game will realise that England are the strong favourites. But, you know, Quinton de Kock, Rabada, you can think of Nokia. They have some fantastic players who can turn a game, who can just flip a game on its head and win it in a five-over segment. And so you can bet your bottom dollar that England, for instance, are not thinking, yeah, we've got this game sewn up. And, yeah, they have plenty to throw at England, South Africa. And they have plenty to prove as well, because yes, you say they have an excellent record against England in World Cups, but they know that they've got a real chance here to go even further in the competition.
Let's talk about the key batters that you were talking about, Rabada versus Jason Roy. And then we've got some numbers. In four innings, two wickets, and he's given 27 runs and 25 balls. So Rabada is leading the way right now.
Well, he's one of the best bowlers in the world for me in all formats. I mean, whether it's T20 cricket, whether it's Test match cricket, I just love watching him bowl. I love his body language. I love the way he attacks opening batsmen. You make some good points there about the matchup with Jason Roy. The one thing you know about Jason Roy is that he's not going to hold back. You know, he will not, I don't think he'll even be aware of any matchups. He'll just be saying, white ball coming at me. I am just going to smack this out of the park.
So another key battle there is Quinton de Kock and Chris Jordan. And like we very correctly mentioned right in the beginning, that for England, it's not just the batting unit, but also the bowling unit is clicking very well, firing from all cylinders. And you've got these numbers of Chris Jordan against Quinton de Kock in 6 innings. He's got him thrice, given 35 runs and just 20 balls.
That is going to be a key matchup. But it'd be interesting to see for me how Morgan uses that, because Morgan's so clever with how he maneuvers his bowlers. I mean, historically, Jordan is used more in the middle of the overs and definitely at the end. He's not used so much with the new ball against someone like Quinton de Kock. So, yeah, the numbers are telling us that. And it'll be interesting to see if Morgan just changes his plan a little bit. I mean, Jordan is a fantastic bowler at the end. His skill and control. And Quinton de Kock is, I mean, he's got all the shots. I mean, he can play the short ball so well. So England will be so aware of his great strengths. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised, actually, if Quinton de Kock, if they just go off spin against Quinton de Kock.
Right. So they're firing from all cylinders. They've come into this tournament all guns blazing. But if you had to tell me three things that they could do to elevate their gameplay even further, especially when they are at the cusp of a semi-final, what would it be?
They'd like to see runs from Livingston, Bairstow, Milan. I mean, they know what they're getting at the top of the order. So if they do happen to lose a couple of the wickets, they're just strengthening their batting resources and they've got all the players to do it.
Number two,
I think in Sharjah against South Africa, I think Moeen Ali and Adil Rashid, when you play in England, Morgan doesn't always like to play Rashid and Moeen Ali on smaller grounds. So that just might be a challenge. I mean, Rashid is bowling brilliantly. Moeen Ali is so clever and they're both fantastic bowlers. But these conditions may test them as well.
To number three, last but not the least.
Number three. I guess being clinical with the ball and continuing to be clinical with the ball.
So Nick, what would be your advice for South Africa as they're going to face a very motivated English side? So what do they do for an unmatched performance?
Take them on. Take this English side on, because they're not going to hang back. They're not going to sit back. And if you don't go at them, they're just going to walk all over you. I really strongly believe they're so confident and they've got so much, all their bases are covered. And I think that you've got players like Quinton de Kock, you've got form players like Nokia and Rabada. And I think their message needs to be, we are going to go all out. We are going to go all out.
All right, South Africa, you heard it. That's Nick Knight's advice to you for an unmatched performance. Who do you think is the biggest threat from South Africa in the game today? Who are your players to watch out for from the other team?
Right, well, I don't think there's too much more needs to be said about Kagiso Rabada and Henrik Nokia. I think they're terrific. I think they've obviously had the advantage of playing in the IPL. So they're very happy with conditions that they're bowling on. I love the way Nokia has developed as a cricketer in all formats of the game, actually. When you look at the batting, you're not going much further than Quinton de Kock. I mean, he is, wow. I mean, he's one of the best players in the world. I love watching him bat. He's got all the shots. You go forward, front foot, he whacks you. You go back foot, he whacks you. That might just be an interesting matchup, though, Moeen Ali against him. If in the early overs, they may not decide to do that. But they've got some good players. Markram scored some nice runs as well.
Yeah. Quick predictions, England or South Africa it is for you, because let me tell you, South Africa would be coming with a lot of motivation themselves, because this is a do or die match for them.
I mean, I strongly believe England will win the game. I mean, these predictions are very difficult in T20 because it only takes a Quinton de Kock or someone like that to go out there and start whacking fours and sixes and the game can turn on its head. But I think England will be too strong in all departments for South Africa in this one.
All right. Super. Thank you so much, Nick. You said it. You've heard the man. England is going to be dominating. And I personally am looking forward to a great innings from Just the Boss yet again. Thank you for watching. Alienware presents SK Yacht. And stay tuned to Sports Kira.